taken in the event of a crisis. In general, a contingency is defined as a situation that occurs that may endanger safety, life, or the environment. Click on the buttons for more information on the various stages of a contingency. Take, for example, a situation in which a hazard or accident has been noticed. This may have either been done by human means or a detector may have registered a problem. When a person notices the problem, they must observe what is happening. Evaluate the situation. Give the proper warnings as described in the alarm instructions. Take actions according to the current situation and their own abilities. The operations unit takes charge of handling the contingency and initiates actions to be taken by the contingency organization, such as making observations from the bridge or by sending someone out on watch, evaluating the situation from the data that has been collected or received, giving the appropriate warnings, calling a staff meeting and getting crew members to muster at their stations. Local authorities initiate measures according to the instructions they have received and will requisition the necessary resources, gather advisors and guidance. The main office is notified and they initiate measures such as setting up a centre for relatives of those involved in the emergency, informing the media. Legal assistance. Establishing a commission. As stated earlier in this module, though the captain has the overall responsibility during a firefighting operation, normally it is either the chief engineer or chief officer that actually leads the fire teams and coordinates their actions. Usually a fire team will consist of 2 to 4 team members. The number of fire teams on board will depend upon the size of the ship, but usually there are at least 2 teams on even the smallest of tankers. In addition to the fire teams, there will also be a first aid team and a technical team. The first aid team is responsible for performing basic medical care on injured persons. The technical team will, in the case of a fire, activate fixed installation extinguishing equipment, and they are responsible for the continued operation of the ship. Upon detecting a fire, there are 3 basic tasks that must be completed: alert, rescue, and extinguish. The order in which these actions are taken will depend upon the situation. However, the primary objectives of a firefighting operation are, first of all, saving lives, and secondly, protecting the environment. This differs slightly from the priorities of firefighting operations on land, due to the fact that fires at sea can have far more serious consequences than, for example, a burning house. Click on the buttons below for more information on these subjects. As long as it is reasonable to do so, the best thing to do is attack a fire immediately upon its detection with a full show of force. That is why it is important that the bridge is notified immediately upon detection, either directly through the shipboard communications network or by automatic alarms or other warning systems. During the initial phase of a fire, it is the duty of the person that discovered the fire to attempt to rescue lives, as long as their actions do not endanger further loss of life. As soon as firefighting teams get involved, their actions must also be aimed at saving lives, as well as following the commands made by the persons coordinating the operation. The term rescue can have many meanings, the most obvious being getting people out of the danger zone and to a safe place. Less obvious are fire control measures, such as cooling walls and passageways to limit the spread of fire, closing ventilation ports to limit the spread of smoke, removing flasks of gas and turning off the electricity, closing off the area. If necessary, evacuation of the vessel. During the initial phase of the firefighting operation, if there is any suspicion that crew members are missing or perhaps trapped, the fire team's activities will be concentrated on rescue-orientated firefighting. In other words, the teams will work through accommodations and other populated areas in order to save lives. If this is not necessary, the teams will simply search through the area before taking an offensive on extinguishing the fire. This will, of course, depend upon the situation. In some situations, it will simply be impossible to enter an area before the fire is under control. However, in such situations, the lives of those in the fire zone have already been lost.